I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. Greetings, technicians. This is Admin Crow here, your coach of the Toronto Star Raptors, bringing you the team builder for another week in the PCL, the Pokemon Champions League. This week is the first week that we are coming back from the 1 week off prior to playoffs. So this is the first team builder for the playoffs. We are taking on Fury, who's one of our divisional rivals, I guess. We're still trying to fight it out. I guess not so much divisional rival, but conference rival. His entire roster and his team should appear to your right momentarily. And I'm just gonna break the fourth wall. This is one of those situations where the team builders are actually post-recorded, so the match has already been played. I'm gonna make this team builder going over the things, or I guess mons that I expect him to bring, not what he actually brought, without actually spoiling the match itself. So let's just hop right into it. First up, we do have Kurogiri the Kofak, packing a Rocky Helmet and the Ability Mummy, of course, and the moves are Pain Split, Hidden Power Fighting, Knockoff, and Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball is there for general stab, mainly for the Alolan Marowak, and Knockoff for everything barring the Mega Lopunny, and Hidden Power Fighting for the Mega Lopunny. And he's whatchamacallit, Bisharp, and Pain Split is there to get back health against his fatter mons. So looking at his roster, it's very fighting weak, and I did trade him my Megalopunny earlier this season, and my Slowking, which I have to prep for both. That's why I have the Shadow Ball. Actually, the other thing would be the Slowking and just my general stab. So the idea is to switch this thing, basically act as a designated switch into both the Zangoose and Megalopunny, more so the Megalopunny, because I don't think he's bringing Zangoose this game. In my opinion, just a lesser Megalopunny. And once I do switch into that Megalopunny, I will be able to pass on my Ability Mummy, so he will lose his Scrappy ability on the following turn if he so decides to go for a Fake Out or anything like that. He won't be able to touch me, and I'll be basically free to fire off a knockoff, since most likely he's gonna be switching out once he loses that Scrappy ability. And as for the Zangoose, unless it's running knockoff similar to last time, it's not gonna be able to touch me with his dual stab, obviously, but fighting, which is close combat or facade. And once I pass on his my mummy ability, his knockoffs are also going to be doing less, simply because his toxic boost is going to be removed as well, assuming he's rocking that toxic orb along with the toxic boost ability, which is very likely. And initially I had Will-O-Wisp on this set along with Psychic to hit a Megalopunny, but then in my mocks against Lo-Fi, I realized that he's just gonna switch out most likely once he loses his Scrappy ability against my Kofak. So there's not really too much reason for me to run a Psychic, so I end up going with Hidden Power Fighting, this helped me hit, obviously, like I mentioned before, both the Megalopunny and the Bisharp. The Bisharp is also a really good switch into the Kofak overall, because he does resist my stab and gives him offensive momentum. It's actually one of the, actually if not the most threatening mon against my roster, if I have to be honest, simply because it checks both of my tier 1 picks, my round 1 and round 2 picks actually. It's a steel type that beats Victini, and it's a dark type that beats Clefable, which is very threatening in a sense. And it is definitely a huge problem against my team. I fully expect it to come. And I do have a designated switch into that thing, as you guys will see a little bit later. And also, you guys can see that I am bringing both the Victini and Clefable against the Bisharp, regardless of my type of disadvantage or just disadvantage in terms of matchup, simply because I do need a Victini to break his dual steel type
mainly the Solar Steel are from the fire side, as I don't have electric type on my team. So that's something else that's coming back to bite me a little bit later in the season. Yeah, so the EV spreads, in case I didn't mention, just max HP and mostly physical defense with both nature to take on the Mega Lopunny. And of course, up next we do have Aura the Victini packing the Cobra Berry this time. I think this is the first time I'm running a defensive item on Victini, as opposed to a Choice Scarf or Choice Band variant, or even Weakness Policy one, simply because I need a Cobra Berry to be able to just stay in and hit the Bisharp if I am in against it. There is another reason I have to pack the Cobra Berry, simply because it allows me to live a Sucker Punch or a Pursuit if I do stay in at minus one, once I do have that defense drop from the V-Create. Last time I brought a physically offensive Victini with Choice Band against them, so this time I really didn't want to run a physically offensive variant. However, though, because I traded him my Slowking, which actually resists Victini's dual stab, and if he is packing a Assault Vest variant, he can pretty much take any hits from Victini, even the Thunderbolts, very well. That's why I want to try to hit it from the physical side. I was forced to run an Adamant Nature as well on top of the physical offense I am running. The movesets are pretty straightforward, just U-turn for momentum and Bolt Strike primarily for the Slowking, and V-Create for everything else, then Headbutt for his Fire Resist, mainly being the Alolan Marowak, and I think the other one would be the Rotom Heat. And the EV spreads are very straightforward as well. Because I want to have as much power as possible, I'm going with Adamant instead of Jolly. I actually didn't EV this thing to outrun the Zangoose, simply because I don't think it's going to come. I can't prep for everything. I have to prep for the things that are more likely to come. And because his team is relatively slow, the next thing, or the next benchmark I was trying to hit, was a Jolly Max Speed Dragon Dancing set Como O, which I believe have a base speed of 85. I just ran enough speed to outrun that. And up next, we do have John the Clefable packing the Key Berry, my favorite set, of course, packing the Unaware ability, simply because I needed to go up against potential setup Celesteela, setup Bisharp if I have to, and mainly for the Leaf Storm coming from Superior, and potential Belly Drumming or Calm Mind Slurpuff. And the movesets are pretty straightforward as well. Calm Mind, Moonlight, Flamethrower, and Moonblast. Moonblast for Stab, Flamethrower for the Bisharp, and Celesteela. I do have to be careful with that potential weakness policy, which is something Fury loves to bring throughout the season. I have to make sure the Celesteela is weakened enough, or I am at plus one or plus two before I can fire off a Flamethrower. And Moonlight is obviously there for recovery. I am unaware, so I have to run Moonlight over Soft Boil. And Calm Mind, obviously, is Calm Mind. It's Clef, right? You need Calm Mind on Clef. And the moves, the EV spreads are very straightforward as well. His team is very physically offensive, so I am running max HP and mostly physical defense, a little bit in special defense to help with the Calm Mind, and a little bit in speed in case he's trying to speed creep my Clefable with his base 50 mons or 45 mons, mainly being the Alolan Marowak and Celesteela. Celesteela naturally outspeeds Clefable anyway, but he does bring a more defensive variant. I do outspeed with this investment. So up next we do have Roshan the Dawn Fam packing the Figgy Berry once again, in combination with that sturdy ability, allows me to take a hit and eat off that juicy berry. Of course we have both Stealth Rock and Rapid Spin. It's my hazard control this week, along with Earthquake and Rock Tomb. So Rock Tomb is very interesting. It basically gives me a move to hit the Rotom Heat with, as I think he's probably gonna bring it, as it does match up well against both the Toxapex and the Victini, as a Fire Resist and a soft track to Rotom, Toxapex. So this, initially I had an assault vest variant, but because the lack of hazard control on Fury's team, I believe he only has two defoggers and no rapid spinners. I don't count Smeargle as a defogger, but I think, I'm not sure if Slurpuff gets defogged, but his primary way of getting rid of hazards would be defog on Rotom Heat and defog on Superior. As I don't think he's gonna run defog on Superior, his only hazard removal would be that Rotom Heat. So another reason that I think Rotom Heat is coming, is very likely to come. So I think he's gonna bring both of his steel types and Rotom Heat, and the rest are up in the air. Maybe that's Smeargle actually. He hasn't been bringing it too much this season, but Lo-Fi did bring it against me in the mock for, I think it was a Web's plus, basically just a standard hazard Smeargle set. That's why I wanted Rapid Spin to hazard control for myself. I didn't want to bring Defog simply because I want to take advantage of his lack of hazard control. And Rock Tomb, obviously, as I mentioned before, it helped me hit the Rotom. Initially, I had Facade on this set, so that I can freely switch into a Will-O-Wisp or Toxic coming, or even T-Wave obviously coming from the Rotom Heat, and be able to fire off a really big hit against it. But I opt to go against it simply because I couldn't touch the Celesteela otherwise. And Rock Tomb also gives me speed control if he so decide to switch to his Celesteela on my Donphan. I can prevent his setup, or I guess just somewhat neutralize his potential autonomize coming from Celesteela. And EV's threats are pretty straightforward as well, max HP with mostly special defense, as I did say that this is going to be my designated switch into that Rotom Heat to block his potential Volt switches and stop his momentum, and just a little bit in attack and defense as well. And oh wait, I think I skipped a member. Yes, we do have Incursio the Hydreigon packing a Choice Scarf again. I didn't really want to bring Choice Scarf again on the Hydreigon, but it is the most potent set in my opinion, and I need a way to outspeed the Mega Lopunny, so I'm actually forced to, despite the fact that I don't really want to run Choice Scarf Hydreigon this time around, especially seeing the playoff. I want to bring something different. And the movesets are very standard as well. Dark Pulse with U-Turn, Draco Meteor, and Flamethrower. Flamethrower is specifically for that Bisharp and the Celesteela. And Dark Pulse is my main click. U-Turn is there for momentum if I have to. Draco is there once I get rid of the Slurpuff, which he might very well bring for the Hydreigon specifically. But otherwise, like the Flamethrower has to, I have to bring the Flamethrower simply because otherwise Bisharp is going to resist my dual stab. And the other reason being that I want a good neutral or a good move to hit the Celesteela with without having to go for Dark Poses. And finally, we do have Wintel Jr. and Toxapex. Packing a Ground DMZ and the Ability Regenerator. The movesets are Recover, Toxic Spikes, Haze, and Scald. Very standard set here. Toxic Spikes, obviously I want to take advantage of his lack of hazard control. However, though, looking at his roster, his mons are either not grounded or steel types. So T-Spikes are actually not very good against him, but I need to bring it in case he doesn't bring hazard control, and specifically for that potential sub Alolan Marowak or sub Superior. So that's what I have Toxic Spikes for over Toxic. I was really debating on whether if I should have Toxic or Toxic Spikes on this slot. Hopefully it doesn't come back to bite me, but the main reason I didn't have Toxic is because I have to play a lot more on prediction, and if he does bring substitute on both of these mons that I mentioned, being the Alolan Marowak or the Superior, I'll be huge ton, like a fuck ton of trouble if they go for sub the turn I go for Toxic. And Haze obviously is there for the SERP and his setup, like I mentioned before. Same reason as my unaware Clefable. Recover is there for recovery. Scald is there for Scald. And Rock'em Z is simply because with my EV spread, max HP, and mostly physically defensive and a little bit in speed def, bold nature, I guarantee to live a plus 2 knockoff into a regular knockoff, and also a plus 2 Adamant Life Orb Psycho Cut coming from a Bisharp if I am at more than 90%. So I know that's oddly specific, simply because I had a set against Lo-Fi in my mock, and I EV'd it to not get 2 KO by non-Life Orb Adamant Bisharp, plus 2 with knockoff, simply because he's not going to go for Sucker Punch against Toxapex, right? Unless he's running Night Slash, he's not going to be able to 2 KO me with any move he goes for, barring Psycho Cut. And I didn't actually prep for Psycho Cut until Lo-Fi brought it against me and blow me back in one hit. Well, actually, he didn't blow me back. He did like 84% with Psycho Cut, and then really caught me off guard. So that's what this set is for. So initially, I actually had Blue Orb on Toxapex. So it's actually very interesting because I was trying to meme it up a little bit. The idea is that the team name for Fury's team is... Oh yeah, I didn't mention we are playing against Fury. The coach of the Primordial Code Surgers. My bad, my apologies if I didn't mention that earlier in my team builder. But you guys should see it in the title anyways. And my idea was a Blue Orb, obviously, because he's a Primordial Code Surgers, right? You gotta have the Blue Orb to go for that primal form with the Kyogre. But unfortunately, I did some testing with Lo-Fi. So apparently how the Mega Evolution or Primal item works is that you still take that additional damage and the item still do get knocked off if you're not the right Pokemon. So I actually tried. So it was a bummer, of course, I don't get to meme it up. I really wanted the Blue Orb to work on the Toxapex, so I can bring a Primal Toxapex potentially. I was forced to go with Rock'em Z, which sucks. I also tried putting Sidorite, which is my Mega Stone, on this. It didn't work, it just got straight up knocked off. So that was kind of funny, but it was good to know. So yeah, that's gonna be it for me with my team this week. I do have some regret with this team. You guys will see in the battle itself and just my draft overall this season. I hope the Raptors can pop a W against Fury, and you guys will have to wait for the actual match to find out. It's gonna be Admin Crow here, signing off. See you in the next one. Goodbye, technicians.